Kid, seriously. So if we go back to our historical roots of this over a year now running show, we started out as a Star Wars show and we worked very heavily with trailers, and wow, worlds are colliding because there was a Star Wars trailer. We're only getting one movie this year because apparently we're all fatigued or whatever. But we have a little bit of a diverse crowd here with this new trilogy because Maya, you love The Force Awakens, did not like The Last Jedi at all. Mark and I are in the opposite camp where we weren't thrilled with The Force Awakens, but we love The Last Jedi. So we have the third movie, Rise of Skywalker, the return of J.J. Abrams, the return of Lando, the return of probably a lot of things. We got our first trailer. It doesn't give us a lot, but let's start out with you, Maya. What do you feel after seeing this trailer?
Well, I think I was very underwhelmed by the trailer. And I think there's a lot of potholes that this movie could really get stuck in. I kind of like some of it, but really we start off right away in the trailer and we got some like ninja stuff going on, and I just wasn't feeling it. We assume that that's Kylo Ren's TIE fighter, but we never see his face for reasons that I'm going to speculate later.
Well, and that shot of his hands, just because they show hands doesn't mean that that is a shot from that sequence. That could be a shot from any point in the movie.
Correct. It's kind of a spicy looking TIE fighter though, so I can see why people are assuming that it's cut in the way that it was cut. Obviously, I think visually this trailer didn't do a lot for me, or at least what I would come to expect from great Star Wars trailers. There wasn't a huge emotional tug that I felt like I did with Rogue One's trailer, like I did with The Last Jedi's trailer, like I did with the Solo trailers or The Force Awakens. I've loved so many of the trailers that Star Wars has put out, and this one was just kind of like blah. And when we got to the end with the Emperor sort of chuckling, like I was just kind of over the trailer. Now, I watched it a couple times since then, and I got into it a little bit more, and I rationalized things in my head and said, oh, this could be this or this could be that, but if you have to explain away the trailer, it's not a very good trailer.
Couple things. The content of the trailer, I found it very underwhelming. It's so lacking in any sort of context for anything that you're seeing. It was random images. And I realized, you know, obviously at this point, it's a Star Wars film. You sort of know what you're getting. And, you know, you're not going to... You know, it's not like the trailer for Swim Fan, if anybody remembers that, which basically outlined the entire movie in a minute and a half. So that's a real deep cut reference that I expect nobody's going to get other than me.
Erica Christensen.
Yes, exactly. Thank you. I knew you could rescue me there. So, yeah, I know I'm not going to get the entire plot outline, but to at least have some idea of what I watching or what I could be in for, it completely didn't have any of that. And the few cues that it did include have filled me with absolute dread. When we get into the whole speculation, every kind of idea I have for what this movie might be, I am scared and do not have faith in them executing or have faith in them presenting a story that I want to see.
So I think Maya put it in words better than I actually was going to with if you're making excuses for all the things. Because when I first saw this trailer, they have that opening scene with Rey, and my first thought when they do like the slowdown is I was like, wow, that's very Zack Snyder-ish to like have the action slow down as she's jumping in the air and then speed back up. And then, you know, the Emperor laugh I absolutely hate because that guy's arc is done. Like, he's a great character, but he's done. Like, let it go. And the name of the movie itself was a big letdown to me. It felt like a very reactionary trailer. It felt like a marketing group had sat in the internet chat rooms and figured out what they think the angriest Star Wars fans from The Last Jedi would want in a movie, and they tried to put that into this trailer. Now, as Maya's mentioned, in my head, I've gone and over time been able to back away ways where maybe it's not that bad, but the trailer left a bad taste in my mouth because I do not want just a nostalgia remake of previous movies. I want to go in new directions, and I'm worried that this is not doing that. And we'll have to see. Abrams has a mixed track record. You know, you could look at The Force Awakens, and which is a massively successful movie, and it's a remake and it's very nostalgia heavy, and maybe they needed that after the prequels. But you could also look at his Star Trek movies, because he really redefined Star Trek with that first Star Trek movie, and then he just made a nostalgia remake of The Wrath of Khan with the second one. So I'm nervous going forward about what this movie's going to be, but I am very interested to hear some theories on what this movie's going to be. So Maya, we'll toss it back to you. What are some of these theories you've been putting together?
Well, the first thing that I want to talk about is when we see trailers for J.J. Abrams movies, at least to my recollection, the movies are pretty, like, what you see in the trailers is pretty much what you get. And I'm thinking about The Force Awakens and the Star Trek movies. Like, we thought that it was Khan, and it was Khan. And we thought that it was going to be a different take on Captain Kirk, and it was a different take on Captain Kirk. And we thought for The Force Awakens that, you know, there was going to be a new guy who was kind of like the Emperor. And all of these things sort of came true. And you look, like, the greatest Force Awakens trailer was the one that starts with Rey in the Star Destroyer. Like, everything was pretty much by the book. What you saw in those first trailers is what happened in the movies. That's what has me the most worried. As far as my speculation, I am hoping for, I'm hoping for the following things. That the Emperor is not really alive. That J.J. Abrams is taking from the comic books and from the novels, where the Emperor has, like, recordings of himself that, like, pop up, and initiatives that pop up, that he's not really alive, but it's sort of like the vestiges of that in some way. I don't think that's going to be the case, but that's what I'm hoping for. We talk about the name, Rey Skywalker. It could be that Rey is Skywalker. It could be that Kylo Ren gets redeemed. I'm hoping for a third option. I'm hoping that it actually means that, like, Luke Skywalker is able to bridge that gap from, you know, that Qui-Gon Jinn started and that Yoda and Obi-Wan have, where basically he's still a Force ghost, but he can completely control, you know, the world around him. He can basically be part of the world, which we saw. I think it would be a cool shout out to The Last Jedi and the things that we saw in The Last Jedi and saw that the way that the Force changed. The final thing, you know, I guess what I should say is if we get that Luke is going to have a bigger role, it would kind of leave a bad taste in my mouth. And the reason it leave a bad taste in my mouth is because this should be Rey's moment. It should be Rey's movie. And if it goes back to having either it be mostly about Kylo Ren or mostly about Luke Skywalker, we're going to think of this trilogy differently. And I don't think that's fair. I think Rey is a good enough character where this should be her story, and I get the feeling that it's not going to be. The saddest part for me, if we had to go through The Last Jedi and the awfulness of what that movie was and what that movie did and what that movie meant, then we might as well get the changes and the good parts that come from it. And I don't know if we're going to get that. I think I was hoping that this next movie would make me like The Last Jedi more. I think it may make me like The Last Jedi even less.
Well, lots of movies make you like The Last Jedi. Last, Mark, what are yours?
My speculation is that I'm really afraid, because my understanding is prior to Carrie Fisher's death, the third episode was always supposed to be, my understanding was, a Leia-centric. The first one was Han, the second one was Luke, the third one was going to be Leia. So it's a pretty safe assumption that whatever Abrams had plotted out back when he did The Force Awakens had to be largely abandoned for this movie. And that meant that they're probably doing a lot of stuff on the fly. So we have the title, The Rise of Skywalker, and kind of the first obvious thing is going to be, oh, well, then that means Rey is actually a Skywalker, which would be a really bad, I think, reversal of one of the most interesting parts of The Last Jedi, was basically the revelation that she's nobody, and really kind of leading into the idea that, you know, maybe the Force isn't just for Skywalkers and you know, Sith Lords, but it's for everybody in the universe. I don't think that's what it is, though. My My guess is that The Rise of Skywalker refers to the redemption of Kylo Ren as a substitute for whatever they were going to do with Leia, because it now becomes about her son redeeming himself and finding the light. And I think that would be a terrible reversal of some really interesting character work that was done to establish him in The Last Jedi as a completely unique villain for the Star Wars universe in this sort of dangerously impetuous, almost childlike, you know, powerful Sith Lord-esque villain. And I think that they're going to undo that. And I think not only is it not going to work because they don't have the real estate in one movie to undo it, I think it's going to make him a much less interesting character as a result. And I think that their hand was kind of forced with Carrie Fisher dying, and that's where I'm guessing it's going. That's my fear. That's why I'm very apprehensive about this.
Well, I'm going to take, I guess, more of maybe not necessarily, I don't know if any of these will be right, obviously, but more what I'm kind of hoping is going to come with it, because I agree that I think it should be more of a Rey story. I don't want to see Luke be the main character. I don't want the redemption of Kylo Ren for all the reasons Mark said. I think they crossed that bridge in Last Jedi and they went in a direction where that doesn't really work, and it makes him less interesting if you were to do that. And I also agree that I don't want Rey to just suddenly be like, yeah, you do have parents of destiny, and it was all destiny. It wasn't that you earned it on your own, because I think that's a step back in my eyes for her character. So I'm hoping the name refers to two things, and these have been said a lot on the internet. One, that they stop referring to them as Jedi, and maybe they refer to them as Skywalkers. It's a little cheesy going forward, but they have in both movies talked about the failings of the old Jedi Order and how what they do didn't work. So maybe you set up a Jedi Order or Skywalkers or whatever, where you are allowed to, you know, get married and be in love and like embrace some of these other things and get rid of the dogma that you dealt with in the original prequel trilogy. So it's a getting rid of the Jedi Order and this new thing coming up. Or maybe if you're gonna try to, I don't know, almost retcon Rey, maybe it's not that she is an actual Skywalker, but and I heard this on the Weekly Planet. I didn't make it up myself, but that she takes the last name Skywalker. Like, I think that would be a good way of taking it, even though she is still just the parents of nobody, kind of a symbolic torch passing, if you will. And I'm also hoping that the Emperor thing, we do see the ashes of the first Death Star in the movie. I'm hoping that's a beginning of the movie sequence, and that Emperor laugh and Emperor appearance is part of a like Force flashback, like they had in The Force Awakens, where Rey kind of has those visions, that maybe she enters the Death Star and she gets some of those visions or some of his presence or something like that. But man, if he is the main villain of this thing, the Emperor, I'm going to be really, really disappointed. I think that was a worst case scenario that I didn't even envision. So now we just have to wait 6 months to figure out what it actually is. Any final thoughts?
A couple different things. With Rey being the nobody, and I think that was one of the things that I like so much about that, is it really puts you in the place of what Star Wars fans were like in 1977 when the movie came out, where Luke really was just a nobody. One thing that Mark had said, like, there isn't enough real estate to redeem Kylo Ren. Kylo Ren is not that much different than not that much worse or different than Darth Vader when you think about it. And I would argue that there was even less in the original trilogy, but we all bought it. I don't know if it's because we were kids or what, but there was plenty of real estate in those movies to get the job done, and that's something that no one even questions now. So that's not the part that doesn't stick with me. That isn't the part that bothers me. The part that bothers me is that the character development of the second movie. Now, I do kind of like, you know, we didn't talk anything about him sort of putting his helmet together and restitching it or soldering it back together. And that was the thing that I wanted to talk about. I don't think he's going to have that helmet that he solders together the whole movie. I think, I'm going to call this right now, I think he's wearing the Darth Vader helmet at the end of the movie. I think he's going to go like full on Darth Vader wannabe to end it where the whole movies began on Tatooine against Rey.
And I think that that could be a possibility, and I like that better than redeeming him. And it isn't that, you're right, Darth Vader did some absolutely horrible things, but most of the most horrible things we find out about Vader, we find out after he is redeemed, because they were in the prequels. Though he still did blow up all those people on Alderaan, and that's not very good. But I think the difference between their stories isn't their ability to be redeemed. It's the fact that we just did a whole movie about whether he could be redeemed or not. And I don't want to watch another movie about whether he can be redeemed or not, because I just watched one. And I liked the answer I got in that. As far as his helmet goes, that was one of the things I really liked in Last Jedi, is that it made him his own character. Because in The Force Awakens, he is a facsimile for Darth Vader. They're trying to recreate Darth Vader. And what I liked that they did with him in The Last Jedi is they made him his own character who stood up on his own without having to be a guy in a cosplay. And him smashing that mask, to me, was symbolic of him becoming his own character and becoming a more interesting character because he was his own character with his own motivations and his own things he was trying to do. So I hope they don't go that route. I have read that there might be some type of like relic collectors that might be like other villains in this movie that are like dark side relic collectors. So I hope it's part of that. We never actually see him wear the mask. We barely see him at all. But I really, really hope he doesn't put that on. But if my options are he gets redeemed or he puts a mask on, I'll take the mask. I'm slightly worried I'm getting both.
So a couple things for me. One, the smashing of the mask for me was everything you said, Luke, but it was also part of the will he or won't he as far as redeeming him in the second arc. Since we've confirmed that he's not going to be redeemed, at least theoretically, for him to then kind of be a child and like, well, I'm going to put the mask back on, or I'm going to wear Darth Vader's mask, that feels in character to me now, in that he is kind of that impulsive, rash, childish sort of villain. And I could see him going back to that as being another element of that, now that we know, okay, he's not redeemable, or at least he shouldn't be based on what we saw in The Last Jedi. To your point, Maya, about Darth Vader in Return of the Jedi, I actually don't think that they successfully redeemed him in that movie. I think if you go back and you watch the original three movies, his turn at the end isn't earned. I don't think it is. I think it's just that it was 1983 and we didn't have so many similar narratives that we weren't as critical of it at that point in time as we would be now. That actually extends to a lot of the original trilogy, where I think if you go back, there's lots of things in there that I think if you're being critical, actually, there's a lot more wrong with those movies than anybody ever really pays attention to, because we view them through nostalgia. So,
well, we are about point to wrap this up, but let's give last word to Maya.
I think, you know, it'll be interesting to me when this is all over how we view this trilogy. And part of what's sticking in my mind is there's been so much turmoil from people who like The Force Awakens versus people who like The Last Jedi. To me, it's like a meta sort of allegory to the world in which we find ourselves currently. And I think it's going to be, I think the way that everybody's going to feel about this whole series when it's over is that everyone is going to hate it for opposite reasons, just like the world we currently live in.
And on that positive note, where can we find you on Twitter, Maya?
I'm at Maya Madrid, chipper and happy.
I'm at Mark_Neitzel23.
Luke_Neitzel, we are Kids Seriously, and we will see you next time.
See ya.